Hey guys, it is Miss Simrino. If you are returning to the channel, welcome back. And if you are brand new, I am very excited that you decided to join me here today for another speed build. And today we are just building another family home. I think I'm calling it a country family home, which I have done before. I have at least like one or two other country family homes on my channel, so clearly I'm starting to run out of ideas to name all of these different homes that are mainly suited for families. But the reason that this is called a country family home is because the interior is very country, in my opinion, a little bit more rustic, and essentially the highlight of this build is the country kitchen kit that we recently got. I almost called it the country kitchen kit pack kit. Like, I was about to name it two or three different things at the same time. I have no idea. They're very hard to say. Have you guys noticed that? The kit names? Like, I'm thinking of what, the throwback kit? The throwback fit kit? Is that what it is? It's just a mouthful. But anyway, this is a family home that is suited for a couple of parents and their two children, I want to say. I can't remember off the top of my head. I am pre-recording, as I've been doing a lot lately. It is very, very odd. So I'm going to put this out there. I have been so ahead of my own schedule that it is actually frightening for me. Like, I'm genuinely so ahead. I think I have 8 to 10 builds at this moment, like right now on this day. I have 8 to 10 builds that are already prepped, ready to go, uploaded to YouTube, scheduled for release. If you guys didn't know, since I upload, I think maybe like 2 builds a week is what I'm striving for at this point. That is what, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. I've got like 5 weeks worth of builds out right now. So if there's anything that is missing from an update that's coming very soon, like in March, we're supposed to be getting bunk beds. If there's something missing, like I didn't use bunk beds in an opportune place, it's because I did this weeks in advance. I just figured I would toss that out there because you're going to, or you probably already have, started to see the new items from the 21st anniversary update like weeks later. And that's because I pre-recorded so freaking much. But anyway, we're pretty much wrapping up the landscaping here, and the exterior is mainly base game, aside from the little flower boxes on the windows, as well as some of the landscaping items. And initially I was thinking it was going to be a base game only home, maybe just with the kitchen kit. But then once I got inside, I was like, no, there's no way. I have to use all of the packs. I want to make this as cozy and rustic as I possibly can. And for that, I felt like I really needed to use the Cats and Dogs expansion because the build and buy just fits perfectly for what I was going for. And I also used the doors from that pack. So if you guys are wondering, Cats and Dogs is actually probably one of my favorite expansions. And oddly enough, not because of the addition of Cats and Dogs. It's actually the build and buy items for me. I don't usually give my families pets because we can't control them like we can our Sims, and we were able to do that in previous iterations of The Sims, I believe. So for me, it was kind of a pitfall, but I do like having cats and dogs in my families because they do add a little bit of, I don't know, realism, right? That's the whole point. But we are inside here. We already fleshed out the floor plan, and this is me trying to figure out exactly what color scheme I wanted to go for in this home, at least in the living room, because more often than not, I have been actually pooling together different wood tones and using them in the same rooms, or just trying to match different colors that may not necessarily be complementary, but they just kind of mesh well, and even patterns. So if we're looking at this rug here and the pattern on the couches, that's like a lot going on, and to me it's a little bit conflicting, but I think once the room was pulled together in its entirety, it looked really nice, so I'm really looking forward to hear what you guys think about this. But we are actually just getting a little side table here. There are two couches and an armchair, so there's plenty of places for your Sims to sit by the fire and watch TV. And I put some of these mounted fish up here because I was thinking that at least one of the parents is really, really into fishing. I don't think that they have fish mounted and plastered like all over the house, because maybe the other parent is just like, look, I know you love fishing, it is a hobby, I am proud of you, but please don't decorate the entire house with your mounted fish, just please. Because that would be me. Like, if my husband was just like, I love fishing and look at all these fish I caught, I want them all mounted, I would be like, that's great, I'm really proud of you, and I don't want to like hide your hobby in any way, shape, or form. But let's not decorate the whole house with your mounted fish. You know, we could have like a room or two. Maybe they can be somewhat scattered, but just not the whole house. So that was kind of my thought there. a long-winded response to that, kind of a long-winded explanation. But over here, we actually put a little Don't Wake the Llama table, which I don't get to use very often because it's fairly big, I would say. It's not the biggest object that we have in The Sims 4, but it does take a decent amount of space to be able to use appropriately and really fit into particular spaces. So I thought that this was a really nice way to use this kind of offshoot of the living room, and I couldn't really think of what else to put there. At first, I was kind of thinking a piano, but I didn't think that a piano really fit this family or this build. It's a very grand Victorian looking piano. Like, it is literally a grand piano, and I was like, that is not what we're going for in this house at all. So the Don't Wake the Llama table was perfect. I also have this other little console table with a few different knickknacks, and I was envisioning this family with a dog. That is why I initially placed that clutter item of the dog treats. But looking back on it, I don't think that I actually placed a food bowl anywhere in this build. So if you are thinking of having like a family with a dog or even a cat, right? Because they use the same exact bowls, doesn't really matter, but you might have to put a food bowl. So I do apologize there. That was kind of my thought. And then I just completely lost track because I built this home over the course of like 3 or 4 days in and out. And I just completely forgot. And I also never put pet beds, at least not big dog beds in my builds, because one, the dogs don't use them. Let's just be honest, they don't. They don't use them and they're just huge. So I never feel as though they fit appropriately in a lot of my homes because they're always super cluttered and they're just so big, I can't really fit them anywhere. It's the same with the Don't Wake the Llama table. But down here is a bathroom. Now, I believe that this is actually just a half bath with a washer and dryer, but I also may, now that I'm seeing this, I may turn it into a full bathroom with a shower tub combo. And I think I actually do keep it that way. And I thought it was a nice addition because upstairs, I think there's only one additional bathroom. It's not always ideal. I don't always want to put a full bathroom on the first floor. It just doesn't really seem like something that you see a lot. However, if I'm doing like a generations kind of family home or just a bigger house in general, I'd kind of just run out of ideas, honestly, and it's more convenient to have more showers and or bathtubs, especially with a larger family. So in this house, I thought it was at least somewhat appropriate, and then we decorated the entryway real quick, and then we move on to the dining room where I used one of the round dining tables, something that I feel as though I haven't done in so freaking long now, and I was so thrilled that this dining room was actually big enough to be able to place this table with enough chairs for the whole family, and maybe if they had guests over. And I was also able to put a few more decorations in this room, which to me is completely wild considering that the room seemed pretty small, but it ended up working out just fine. But I do kind of move back and forth between the dining room and some other rooms as well because there were a few different decorations that I was finding throughout the menu that I kind of forgot about. And I was like, wait, where can I use this? This seems to kind of match the vibe and the aesthetic that I'm going for in this build. Where can I put this? And then we end up moving on to the kitchen, which, like I said, is basically a kitchen completely designed off of the Country Kitchen kit. I went with, I believe, a blue swatch throughout this entire kitchen, though I did change up the tiling on the walls because it seemed a little bit overwhelming to have blue tiles and then these very, I wouldn't say necessarily vibrant, but they're fairly saturated, this blue swatch for this pack or this kit. I keep calling it a pack. That's never gonna stop. It is a kit, guys. It is a kit. It is smaller than a pack. But I was able to use this shelf that I didn't use the first time I used this kit, and I love that shelf so freaking much. Like, I cannot get over how much I love it. The swatches not only changed the color, but they changed the little design on it as well. Like, look at them. I kind of like flipped through a few to see which one I liked more, but I love this sunflower one so much. And I initially used the parenthood tile, but wow, I did make that decision. I ended up using kind of a blue tile anyway. Well, goes to show, I don't even know who past April is at this point because I went blue on blue, man. I really did. I even used the blue swatch of those cats and dogs dining chairs. So here we are. I loved blue that day. Hope you guys like it too. But we are just kind of cluttering up the kitchen now. I do this very often at this point where I get a console table and I'll put it in the middle of a kitchen as kind of a faux island. So that dining chair in the middle of the kitchen is not usable, but I wanted to make it look as though Sims could sit at that little table and, you know, I don't know, snack on a banana or something. Y'all, you're getting like April with a lot of coffee right now, and sometimes I just don't know where I'm going with half the things I'm saying. I also wanted to make sure that I placed a vacuum in this build because I didn't use the vacuums at all in any builds yet, and that was mainly just because it's more so for gameplay. Like, the things that we got with the Dust the Bus kit are more for gameplay compared to decorating, like build and buy, which is basically what the kitchen kit was for. But I wanted to make sure that there was a vacuum in here just because it is a new item and I'm very excited about it. And I know that there have been some reports that Bust the Dust, which is also a mouthful, I can't say these kit names, the Bust the Dust, see, it's happening, the Bust the Dust kit has been a little bit broken. If you guys have seen at this point, which probably will have, there was like a laundry list of items that they were going to be tending to in the update. So by the time you see this, hopefully a lot of those will be remedied. Hopefully the kit will no longer be, I don't know if I'd say broken, but there are definitely things that need to be, I think, fine-tuned with it. So hopefully that has been tended to by the time you guys see this video. But I am decorating this shelf above the windows here. Now, realistically, I don't think people would be able to get to that top shelf as often as they may need to, especially if there were like cookbooks and stuff up there. But for the sake of The Sims, I just thought it was appropriate to decorate it as is. And then I work on the little back entryway as well, where there really aren't too many things. There's just a few different clutter items, and I actually do take the vacuum and I end up putting it in this room, which ends up being a little bit of an office space and a craft room. So I wasn't sure if it was mainly one of the parents that kind of had their own crafting business. Like, I'm thinking maybe they have their own Plopsy site, right? And that's basically what they do for a living. And maybe they are a stay-at-home parent alongside that. So they kind of run their own home business, but they are also a stay-at-home parent for their kids while they are still school age. And when they, I don't know, go off to college or start high school or something, they plan on jumping back into kind of a regular old 9-to-5 career type thing where they physically go to work, but they took the time now that their kids are younger to be home with them and still be contributing to the household by doing kind of like a home business. So I really liked that idea. And the office, I think, is really cozy. I didn't go crazy with decorations, but there is the good old vacuum, and there's also a chess table in there if the kids want to like play chess, maybe while their parent is doing some work before they go out and do something. I have no idea, but now we're on to the second story, and the floor plan was a little bit wonky. It was a little bit challenging because I knew there were going to be, one, a lot of windows, and two, I knew it was going to be very, very square in the way that all of the rooms were kind of sectioned off, but I wanted to make sure that I got at least 3 bedrooms up here and another bathroom, and I was able to achieve that, which definitely made me happy, but the staircase was a bit of a challenge. And before I even started recording this build, I laid out the floor plan to find out what was best, and it took me probably about an hour to find a floor plan. And this is what I came up with. So if you guys don't like it, definitely feel free to change it up. As always, you can do whatever you want if you download my builds. But yeah, this is the best I could come up with. It was really challenging. And up here, they do have a shower and of course a toilet. So it is technically a 3/4 bath, but they also have a stacked, I was gonna say standing, stacked washer and dryer. So there is laundry in this build. If you don't have laundry day, that will be missing, as well as a few different miscellaneous clutter items, but not too much. And there is also just this little tiny square hallway, if you can even call it that, off to the left-hand side, as you guys can see. And that was so I could actually separate the entrances to the 2 bedrooms. I've been trying to do that a lot more in builds where you don't have to walk through a bedroom or a bathroom to get to another room. Do you know what I mean? I feel like hallways and little dividing spaces like this are more realistic, so I wanted to make sure that I did that here. I also used a little bit of the tool mod to go ahead and lower some of these mirrors, because we all know that mirrors in The Sims 4, well, at least most of them, are very, very high on the wall, like unnecessarily high. So I always use the tool mod to try to lower them, but you also don't need the tool mod to be able to do that. You can just delete the wall, use the Control 9 key if you were on PC, and actually just raise objects up if you prefer. And this is the master bedroom, which I thought was really cozy. I did struggle in decorating it just a little bit because it was, yet again, bigger than I was anticipating. I really don't know why that is, but it was a lot bigger than I was anticipating. So they do have another bookcase in here, as well as a dresser, and then just a few different pieces of decor, as one would expect in a bedroom. I also use the same mirror pretty much throughout the entire build, or at least on the second story. Oh, and actually, this could technically be a 4-bedroom house, so I failed to mention this, and you guys will see it probably nearing the end of the build, but one of the rooms is fairly small, so my thought was that it wouldn't be great for another kid, because you'd have two kids with these bigger rooms, and then you'd have one that was basically like shafted to the closet type room. So that was my idea, is that it wouldn't necessarily be fair for the kids, but there's one room that's basically a little painting studio, and it's the one kind of right behind the master bedroom. You could turn that into a nursery if you wanted to as well. So that's kind of an idea to make this build maybe work for you and a family that you have in mind. But this is one of the first kids' rooms, and I love it so very much. I can't deny that I love those curtains a lot. Now, I can't remember if those came with Cats and Dogs or My First Pet stuff, the curtains specifically. I know the bed, on the other hand, is from Cats and Dogs, and I absolutely love it, but I thought it was a really soft blue room. I thought it was really, really cute, and I actually used a few different wallpapers upstairs just to kind of change it up a bit. The plain white walls with the brown wood trim was pretty downstairs and it was pretty consistent, but maybe upstairs they just hadn't swapped out the wallpaper because maybe it's an older house or something and the kids didn't care if they had wallpaper in their rooms, and maybe the parents liked the wallpaper in their room because I used the paranormal stuff wallpaper in their room. I think I did it off camera though, but their room is really cute. There's that little sun decal from Seasons, which I am obsessed with. I forget how much I love it, and then I use it, and then I can't stop using it. And they also have a little costume chest. There's a school project in there, but I just kind of used it as clutter compared to something that your Sims would actually use and create, because you need a lot of space to be able to work on those, and that was not the point here. I also cluttered up the desk a little bit here, and it's kind of a combination of blues, whites, and yellow, which is a color combination I often lean towards because blue and yellow just look really nice together in my opinion. But I think that this child sim really, really likes animals, and I don't know if they necessarily want to be a vet, but they want to work with animals in some capacity. Or they just really love them at this point, because we all know that sometimes our interests as children change as we get older. And then this is the other child's bedroom. And now I wasn't thinking if they had like two sons or two daughters or a son and a daughter. It can be, of course, any Sim that you would like it to be. And they're really just based off of interest compared to color schemes, which is something that I do a lot, by the way. I try to be very specific if I was envisioning them having a son or a daughter. But in this build, I think it could be for any Sim that you'd like. And now that chair won't be usable because there is a toy on it, but I thought it was a really cute way to add a little bit more clutter and personalization to this room. And this child Sim, I think, is really into space. I love using those posters from Discover University because they really emphasize interests. And the Sim also has a little bit of a desk in the corner there where they might scribble away in their journal, because I don't like giving kids computers. It's just me. I didn't get a computer. Maybe I'm salty. That's why. I think it's because I'm salty, because I didn't get my own computer for a long time, and having internet on said computer was something that didn't happen until even later. So basically I had a computer to, I don't know, type up things for homework or whatever, or play games, but I wasn't able to use the internet for a while. So maybe I'm just salty. It was a good call. It was a good parenting call. But over here is the little painting room. So one of the parents is maybe a painter and a candle maker. Maybe it's the same parent that kind of has their own little home crafting business. Maybe they are just very well-versed and they create a bunch of different things. I think that's kind of a fun idea. So there's an easel in here and some canvases that are just leaning on the wall. I just love all of those unlocked career items, as well as the candle making station, which I thought was nice. I haven't used that in a little bit, so it was nice to use it here. And then I am going to be working on the backyard, which is fenced in, something I do very, very often. And I thought that it was nice that the fence matched the color of the window boxes, because I was thinking white to match the trim and everything on the house, but I kind of liked the dark brown for a change. It didn't completely match, but I think it worked. And I think in the backyard they do have just a little outdoor dining table. I believe I add a swing set as well for the kids. Thank goodness for Seasons and that swing set. And I think there's a few gardening plots as well, just so there are a few more activities outside for the parents, because maybe they really enjoy gardening as well. I think they're very creative, laid-back Sims, and I think they're hoping that their kids are also going to be the same or have the same interests when they get older. But we are actually almost at the end of the build here, so I hope you guys did enjoy this one. Thanks for bearing with a rambly voiceover as always, and I will catch you next time I post a video, and I will talk to you soon. Bye! I would be up waiting for you if you had to leave. I would wait a lifetime if you were at sea. I just wanna say that I feel that our love is real.
Maybe we should hurry up and seal the deal.
Take you there.